Welcome back, amazing hackers, to part two of this amazing series. Right now, I'm going to teach you guys how to import, because I'm very sure that you've all come across something like this before. Now, in here, this is just an example. Swagger. Swagger is amazing. It completely documents your API, and you don't have to do much for it yourself. Of course, this is fun to play with. This is very fun to play with, but it can be cumbersome. Like, look at how cumbersome all of this is. I have to click open, I have to click on it, I have to click on it. That's way too much for me. And then, of course, you can also authorize, that's also possible. But what I really want to do, and that's the easiest part, I think, wrong tab there. So I want to import it. Like, I can either import a file, of course, a complete folder, I can import a link, which is what we're going to do, or raw text, that's also possible, or we can implement a complete git code repository. Now we want to link it, and then we can immediately see it's found something. It's going to enable that Swagger API. It's going to generate collection from the important APIs. This is important. Either you generate it or you put it in an existing one, but for me, generation is good. Link this collection as documentation. That's good for me. Now you also have some advanced settings that you can play with. Make sure that you look into all of them, because there's some really advanced stuff in there. Then we click on the import button. We wait a little bit, and then we get one API and one collection were important. They'll be in the sidebar in a few seconds. Yeah, right, if it doesn't glitch out, right, guys? And the next step is publish important APIs to private API network. So that's something that still needs to be done. But now let's first have a look at what's new here, because as you can see, they've been so kind to create a new collection for us. That's really useful. That saves us a lot of time. That means that we don't have to do that anymore. Then there's, of course, their pet store, the pet specifically. You can make a post to a pet. You can make a get to a pet. But this is all the theory that we saw in the previous video. And I hope you guys see how cool this can be whenever you come across API documentation. It doesn't even have to be like me right now. What you can very easily do is you can just import it. It can be anything, open API, as long as it's, of course, a data type that is supported. Waddle, open API, GraphQL, curl, blah, blah, blah. Can be a lot of things. Now, of course, there's also possibility to add a link in there, which is what we did. But that's how you import, basically, how you import these WSDL files or WADL files, if you ever come across them in the wild. This might be an option for you. You just import it, and then you can play with it a little bit better. You don't have to use that cumbersome web version anymore. Thank you so much for listening, everybody. It was a pleasure talking about this. And of course, Burp Suite, Postman has a lot more secrets than just this one. Thank you very much, and I will see you in the next one. Bye, amazing hackers.